गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू, आर यू एबल टू हियर मी?
हमारे
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग। अच्छा, टेल मी द लास्ट क्लास, व्हाट आई हैव कंप्लीटेड।
मैम वी वर द लास्ट टॉपिक वी डिस्कस्ड इज फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट।
फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट, वुड आई बी टेकिंग दैट?
No, ma'am. We just discussed about free radicals and photoelectric effect.
Free radicals and what?
I'll send the screenshot on the group.
Photochemical reactions, you might be saying.
Oh yes, photochemical reaction.
Photoelectric effect is there in atomic structure.
This is the last thing that we have done.
Okay.
Quantum fission.
Fine, fine. So now I have to start with reactive intermediates, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
What about the module? Do you all start doing the module?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, when I say the term intermediate, what comes to your mind? Intermediate means what? Intermediate, the term tells you what?
A medium or something which is in between two or more things.
Yeah. Can I say it's a species formed in between reactions? Yes, so intermediates, just write down. Intermediates are species which are formed in between reactions. Intermediates are species which are formed in between reactions. These are neither the reactant nor the product of any reaction. These are neither the reactant nor any product of a reaction. No, Sushmita, I'll take one more class to complete yours. Okay, that means, can I say the intermediates don't exist as such? They just are formed in between reactions and they can neither exist in the form of any reactant or any product of a reaction. I'll explain you the formation of an intermediate with the help of a graph. This graph which I'm drawing here is now known as the energy profile diagram. It's a graph of potential energy. Against the progress of the reaction. Supposing at zero time, that means here, I'm starting with a reactant whose potential energy is somewhere here. Okay. So this is the energy which the reactant has. Now to this reactant, I add the reagent and I start heating. When I start heating this reactant, what will happen? What will happen to the energy of the reactant?
Increase.
Yeah, it will keep on increasing because the molecule will start moving faster, vibrate, rotate. So all those forms of energy in the molecule will start increasing its potential energy. And if I've supplied a sufficient amount of energy to the molecule in order to break one of its bond, then at that instant, the bond of the molecule, one of the bond of the molecule will break. And this is where you get the formation of intermediate. You can see the potential energy of the intermediate is extremely high. Therefore, can I say the intermediate is actually a species which is very unstable due to its high potential energy? And this we get by breaking one or more bonds in the reactant. When the bond breaks in the reactant, the intermediate is formed. The intermediate has extremely high energy, means very low stability. It cannot exist in this form. So now this starts combining with the reagent to form the product of the reaction. Okay. So now this intermediate will then give you the product of the reaction. Now this energy which you have provided in order to form the intermediate or in order to break the bond in the reactant is called as activation energy. Basically, activation energy is nothing but bond energy. Because this is the energy which you are providing in order to form the intermediate. And how are intermediates obtained? They are obtained by breaking one or more bonds present in the reactant. Fine? Now, how much energy have you provided in this reaction? Can I say energy equivalent to EA? Yes?
Yes.
So that is the energy which you are providing in order to form the intermediate. Now the intermediate is going to give you the product. How much energy is going the intermediate going to give you back?
EA plus enthalpy.
Huh. Can I say it will be more than what energy you have supplied? So the intermediate is going to give you back the EA and this. This is known as the overall liberation of energy, which is known as delta H. Have you heard about delta H? Kya hota hai?
Yes, thermochemistry.
Yes, it is a heat of reaction. Also known as the enthalpy change. Can I describe this process in the graph as an exothermic process?
Yes.
Why exothermic?
Because heat supplied is less than heat released.
Yes, because the heat which I have supplied is equal to EA. But the heat which is liberated here, can I say it is EA plus delta H?
Yes,
right? Huh. So the energy liberated out is more than the energy which you have provided. And therefore, this reaction can be classified as an exothermic reaction. Could you tell me how would a graph of an endothermic reaction look like?
The level of like the where you have marked the R will be lower. Then the graph will go up and the product will be somewhere in between the I and the R.
Yes. Okay. So if this is your reactant here, you are providing the energy so as to break the bond in the molecule. Here is where you'll get the formation of intermediate. And this is somewhere you'll have your product. So how much energy are you going to provide here? Energy equivalent to EA. And how much is the intermediate giving you back?
EA minus enthalpy.
This is the net energy absorbed. Okay. So this delta H will be the net energy absorbed. Here the delta H will be the net energy liberated in the process. This graph represents an endothermic process. So can I conclude from these graphs that whether exothermic or endothermic, energy has to be first supplied to the reactant. Then only the reaction will proceed ahead. Correct? Initially, energy has to be supplied in the form of activation energy. Then only the reaction will proceed ahead. Because activation energy is actually doing what? It is breaking the bond in the reactant. If you don't provide activation energy, will the bond in the molecule break?
No.
And if the bond doesn't break, can I say reaction will not occur?
Yeah.
Okay. So if the bond doesn't break, the reaction will not occur. Is this clear? Is this clear?
Yeah.
So for breaking a bond in the molecule, you have to provide energy which is equivalent to activation energy. So how do spontaneous reactions occur? You know what are spontaneous reactions?
Feasible reaction.
The reactions which occur without any energy being provided. So how do spontaneous reactions occur? Because for them, the activation energy is the energy available at room temperature. Fine? So spontaneous reactions ko kaise describe karenge? For them, the activation energy is the energy which is available at room temperature. So the energy of the room temperature is sufficient enough to cause those reactions. Okay. Okay, now based on these graphs, I'll ask you one more question. For which process? Endothermic or exothermic? I repeat, for which process? Endothermic or exothermic? Would the EA of the reaction be always greater than delta H? This condition always has to be satisfied. Would it be an endothermic reaction or an exothermic reaction where EA would always be greater than delta H?
Endothermic.
Yes. Could you explain how?
Ma'am, looking at the graph of the endothermic reaction, we can see that the EA is always something that is your energy supplied plus delta H. So EA will always be greater than delta H.
Yes. Okay. For exothermic reactions, EA can be more than delta H, like I have shown here. Correct? I can have a graph something like this. Can I say here EA will be less than delta H? Correct? I can also have a graph where EA will be equal to delta H. That means ye jitna upward hai, utna hi niche jayega. So there EA will be equal to delta H. So for exothermic reactions, you can have EA greater than delta H. You can have EA less than delta H. You can also have EA equal to delta H. But for endothermic reactions, the EA will always be greater than delta H. Now this part of the graph, the EA part, deals with kinetics of a reaction. What do you mean by the term kinetics? Saad, if both are equal, then it will be an exothermic, no? देखो आई शो इट हियर, यहाँ पर ई है, सॉरी ई ए एंड डेल्टा एच आर इक्वल एंड यू कैन सी द प्रोडक्ट इज लोअर इन एनर्जी देन द रिएक्टेंट. सो हियर ई ए इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा एच. दिस रिप्रेजेंट्स एन एक्सोथर्मिक रिएक्शन. अंडरस्टूड? डेल्टा एच अगर जीरो है तो एनर्जी ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट एंड प्रोडक्ट विल बी सेम, देन इट इज नाइदर एंडोथर्मिक नॉर एक्सोथर्मिक. फाइन
मैम, सो इन दैट केस रिएक्शन अकर ही नहीं होगा ना?
क्यों नहीं होगा? एनर्जी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट इज सेम एज दैट ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट. व्हाई इट वोंट अकर?
मैम, रिएक्शन अकर होगा आइदर टू इनपुट स्टेबिलिटी, दैट इज लॉस ऑफ पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, राइट?
Can't the reactant and product be at the same energy level? They can be, na?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. And what makes you say that the product should always be more stable than the reactant? Will the product of a reaction always be more stable than a reactant? Then endothermic reactions would never occur. Yes, very good, Ojas. Can I say in endothermic reaction, the reactant is more stable than the product? Because reactant ka potential energy lower hai na product se. So reactant ka potential energy kam hai to reactant will be more stable than the product. Am I right? Did you get it? Then why would an endothermic reaction occur? Because we always determine the feasibility of a reaction by this term. What is this term? Delta G kya hota hai? Tell me what is delta G. Yes, the Gibbs free energy. This tells you the feasibility of a reaction. And this depends on two factors. Which are those two factors? Come on, tell me. This depends on two factors. It depends not only on delta H, but it also depends on delta S. Correct? So not only the delta H determines the spontaneity of a process. Even the delta S will determine the spontaneity of a process. Yes. You know that evaporation of water is an endothermic process. Do you agree? But it does occur at room temperature. The reason is because entropy, the entropy change there is positive. Na? Entropy change is highly positive over there because water vapor is being formed from liquid water. So entropy change positive ho jata hai. This entire term becomes highly negative. So delta G tends to become negative over there. And that process becomes spontaneous. So spontaneity of a process is determined by delta G and not only delta H. It depends on both. The spontaneity depends on delta H as well as delta S. That is why even endothermic reactions can occur. Jo endothermic reactions hote hain, why do they occur? Because for them, the entropy change is highly positive. That gives you the overall delta G to become negative. And those reactions will definitely occur. Okay. Is this part clear now? Is this part understood by all of you? Okay.
Yes.
So overall, delta G determines the spontaneity and not endothermicity or exothermicity of any reaction. Fine. Now I was talking about this part of the graph. This part of the graph is going to give me the activation energy. This part of the graph, the activation energy determines the kinetics of a reaction. Now, what do you mean by kinetics? Kinetics means the rate at which a reaction occurs. A reaction requiring very high activation energy. That means, say, you have to provide very high energy for the reaction to occur. In other words, you need very high energy to break the bond in the molecule. Can I say that reaction will occur at a slower rate? Because aapko energy continuously dena pad raha hai. So that reaction will be slower as compared to a reaction which requires less energy to break the bond. This part is clear. So this activation energy, actually find out, from the activation energy, you can find out the rate of a reaction. A reaction requiring lower activation energy will be definitely faster than a reaction requiring higher activation energy. So formation of an intermediate tells you whether a reaction would be fast or slow. Jo intermediate jaldi banega, matlab jo intermediate ka potential energy lower hoga, that intermediate will be formed faster. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Agar intermediate ka potential energy low hai, matlab intermediate yahan hai, I'll have to provide less energy in order to form that intermediate. And therefore, the reaction will be faster. So this part of the graph is going to deal with kinetics. And this part of the graph will tell you the thermodynamics of a process. This will tell you the feasibility of a process, whether it is highly feasible or not. Because delta H determines the feasibility of a process. Spontaneity of a process. So this part of the graph, that is delta H, will deal with the spontaneity or feasibility of a process. In other words, this will tell you about the thermodynamics of a process. But this part of the graph deals with kinetics. That means it will tell you about the rate of a reaction. Ye part jo hai, this will not tell you whether a reaction is going to be fast or slow. It will just tell you whether a reaction would occur or not. But this part will tell you the feasibility, the speed of a reaction, whether the reaction will occur at a faster rate or a slower rate. Is this clear with you, all of you? Understanding this graph is very, very important. It's a very crucial part of this entire organic. Okay. Energy profile diagram I'll be using on and off. Almost every reaction I'll be using energy profile diagram in order to explain you why is the reaction feasible. Did all of you understand this? Okay. So with this in your, keeping this all this in your mind, I'll start with my first intermediate. That is, I'm starting with the types of intermediates. Under this, the first one I'm doing is a carbocation. Fine, write down what is a carbocation. A carbon with a positive charge. A carbon with a positive charge is called as a carbocation. A carbon with a positive charge is called as a carbocation. It is formed during a heterolytic bond fission. It is formed during a heterolytic bond fission.
Ma'am, can you repeat the definition?
Carbon with a positive charge is called as a carbocation. It is formed during a heterolytic bond fission. It can be defined as a carbon having three bond pairs of electrons and a positive charge. A carbon having three bond pairs of electrons and a positive charge. Carbocations are sp2 hybridized. Carbocations are sp2 hybridized with trigonal planar geometry. Okay, did you all finish writing now? So now just let me tell you. Say in a compound you have a carbon bonded to a highly electronegative atom such as a halogen. And you are providing the necessary energy in order to break the CX bond. How would you expect this bond to break? Homolytic or heterolytic?
Heterolytic.
Yes. Which atom would take away the electron pair? Carbon or
halide?
Yes. So when this takes away the electron pair, you'll be left with this. With what charge on carbon?
Positive.
And the halogen gets the negative charge. This what you have got is known as a carbocation. It can be defined as a carbon having three bond pairs of electrons and a positive charge. It is formed during a heterolytic bond fission. And carbocations, we know they are sp2 hybridized, so it will have trigonal planar geometry. Okay, why would a carbocation be unstable, or in other words, why is it an intermediate? Why carbocations don't exist? Because of their incomplete octet. Can I say carbocarbon here is having an incomplete octet?
Yes.
So it is unstable. And that is why these are known as intermediates. This part is understood, all of you? Fine. So now we know that carbocations are unstable because of their incomplete octet. Now what I'm going to discuss here is the relative stability. Of course, all these what I'm writing are unstable. But if I have to compare the relative stability amongst these, what would be the factors determining their stability? We'll discuss those. Okay. So let us take this one. This one is a primary carbocation or 1 degree. Reason being, the carbocation, that is this, is joined to only one other carbon atom. So it's a primary carbocation. This would be a secondary or 2 degree carbocation because the carbocation is joined to two other carbon atoms. And this carbocation now, what I have written is a tertiary carbocation or 3 degree because it is joined to three other carbon atoms, which according to you, of course, all are unstable. But which according to you should be more stable and why?
Third one. 3 degree.
Yes. And what is the reason behind that? What is the reason?
Ma'am, can there also be a 0 degree carbocation?
This is super primary. Super primary carbocation. So now you gave me the stability order as this. And what is the reason? Inductive effect, yes. Inductive effect yahan par maximum hoga. Because carbon needs electrons. And there are three alkyl groups which can show the plus I effect. So they will reduce the deficiency on this carbon. Here there are only two plus I effects from either side, and here there is only one plus I effect. So plus I effect is definitely going to increase its stability. That makes a 3 degree carbocation more stable than 2 degree, and 2 degree being more stable than 1 degree.
But all these three will be generally unstable only, right?
Yeah, all are unstable. This order you all wrote? Okay. Now, one reason I've given you for the stability order is inductive effect. The other reason is hyperconjugation. Now, how would I've done hyperconjugation with y'all, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Hyperconjugation kaise hoga isme? Now, you know, carbocation has is sp2 hybridized. Sp2 hybrid orbitals are used to form these three bonds. There is one unhybridized p orbital on this carbon, which is empty. So what can happen is this CH bond, the electron pair can shift here to form a bond in which this carbon will use its empty orbital to form that bond. So iska jab hyperconjugation hoga, to aisa structure aa jayega. How many alpha hydrogen does this have? You know what are alpha hydrogen? This bromocation is the alpha carbon. All the hydrogen present on those are known as alpha hydrogen. How many alpha hydrogen does this carbocation have? Three. So there will be three hydrogen atoms which can participate in hyperconjugation here. This will have how many alpha hydrogen? This carbocation.
Two.
ये वाले है ना?
Sorry, three.
ये अल्फा कार्बन होगा. द कार्बन जॉइंट टू द कार्बोकोटाइन इज द अल्फा कार्बन. यस, सो इट हैज थ्री अल्फा हाइड्रोजन. दिस कार्बोकोटाइन हैज हाउ मेनी अल्फा हाइड्रोजन? सिक्स. एंड दिस कार्बोकोटाइन हैज हाउ मेनी अल्फा? नाइन. सो ड्यू टू द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ नाइन अल्फा हाइड्रोजन, दिस कार्बोकोटाइन इज मच मोर स्टेबल देन दिस वन, एंड दिस इज अगेन मच मोर स्टेबल देन दिस वन. सो आई हैव गिवन यू टू रीजंस फॉर द स्टेबिलिटी ऑर्डर ऑफ कार्बोकोटाइन्स. One is hyperconjugation and the other is inductive effect. Can I say this is also 2 degree and this is also 2 degree carbocation?
Yes.
When the degree of the carbocation is same, I repeat, when the degree of the carbocation is same, then use hyperconjugation to determine the stability.
2 is more stable than 3 as it has more number of alpha hydrogens.
Say this is A and this is B. Can I say A will be more stable than B?
Yes.
Yes, because A has more alpha hydrogen. So you'll be using hyperconjugation when the degree of the carbocation is same. Like here, both are 2 degree. So when both are of the same degree, then you have to use the hyperconjugative effects to determine the stability order. Is that clear? When the degrees are different, you can simply use inductive effect to determine the order. But when the degree of the carbocation is same, then you have to go and determine the stability order using hyperconjugation. Any questions till here? I'm proceeding ahead. You have finished writing this? Okay, Aisha, write it down. Fine. Okay. So let's proceed. Now both are 1 degree. Which will be more stable, 1 or 2?
2.
Reason?
One
reason,
it has more number of alpha hydrogen.
Can I say here also there is minus I effect? Chlorine will pull electrons from this carbon. Because of that, this carbon will develop what charge? Delta plus. Correct. So will this carbon be able to donate electrons to this carbocation as much as this can donate? So inductive here, is definitely going to be more. Plus I effect is more than this. And moreover, I can say alpha hydrogen are also less in this. So that gives you a stability order of 1 greater than 2. All this what I'm doing is relative stability. Fine. Give me the stability order here.
ACB.
Very good. And what is the reason? Could you explain?
A mein to chlorine hai hi nahi, so there is no minus I effect. So it will be most stable among the three. Between B and C, the B one has only one alpha hydrogen, whereas the C one has two alpha hydrogens.
Yes. And okay, can I also say that chlorine is closer to the carbocation here? So when you have an electron withdrawing group closer to the carbocation, definitely stability would be less. Here the electron withdrawing group is away. So the stability becomes more. So that is why C is more stable than B. These two are both less stable than A. The reason being, in A, there is plus I effect. But in dono mein minus I effect bhi aata hai chlorine. देखो ए एंड सी कैन आई से अल्फा हाइड्रोजन दोनों में सेम है. ए एंड सी हैव द सेम नंबर ऑफ अल्फा हाइड्रोजन. सो हाउ डिड आई कंपेयर द स्टेबिलिटी? दैट वाज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द माइनस आई इफेक्ट शोन बाय क्लोरीन. इज दिस क्लियर?
यस मैम.
हाँ. इन दोनों में से ज्यादा कौन सा स्टेबल है? दिस 1 डिग्री और दिस विनाइलिक कार्बोकैटायन. इसको विनाइलिक क्यों बोलते हैं?
1 डिग्री.
इट्स अ कार्बन हैविंग डबल बॉन्ड. हां, व्हाई इज दिस मोर स्टेबल देन दिस?
हाइपर कंजुगेशन.
ओके, कैन आई से हाइपर कंजुगेशन के साथ साथ दिस कार्बोकैटायन इज व्हाट हाइब्रिडाइज sp2. इसका हाइब्रिडाइजेशन क्या होगा?
एसपी.
हाँ, एसपी. एस कैरेक्टर इज मोर हियर 50%. सो इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी ऑफ कार्बन इज वेरी हाई हियर. एंड इफ इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी इज वेरी हाई, कैन आई से पॉजिटिव चार्ज इज मोर स्टेबल ऑन अ मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एटम एंड लेस स्टेबल ऑन अ मोर इलेक्ट्रो पॉजिटिव एटम? सॉरी सॉरी, I said the reverse. Positive charge will be more stable on a more electropositive atom, correct? Negative charge is more stable on a more electronegative atom, correct? Like if I take sodium chloride, positive kis pe favor hoga? Sodium pe ya chlorine pe? So positive should be on a more electropositive atom. Negative should be on a more electronegative atom. In dono mein se, इसका 50% कैरेक्टर है एस का. एस है, एस कैरेक्टर इज 50%. सो दिस इज मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव कार्बन एज कंपेयर टू दिस. एंड दिस इज मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव, इट शुडंट हैव अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज. सो दैट मेक्स द फर्स्ट वन, दैट इज दिस वन, मोर स्टेबल देन दिस वन. ऑल ऑफ यू गॉट दिस? एंड द सेकेंड रीजन व्हाट शी गेव इज करेक्ट, द नंबर ऑफ हाइपर कॉन्जुगेटिव स्ट्रक्चर्स. One degree or one degree allylic, which should be more stable, and why?
1 degree.
Again, you're counting the number of alpha hydrogen, correct?
Yes.
That means just looking through hyperconjugation. But hyperconjugation is the dominating effect hota hai resonance. This is stabilized by resonance. So one unit positive charge is now being shared between how many carbon atoms? One unit positive charge, it is being shared between two carbon atoms. So can I say the charge on each carbon almost reduces to plus half? So charge becomes smaller. That makes resonating structures here more stable than the 1 degree carbocation. So allylic carbocation is more stable than primary. In fact, it is more stable than secondary as well. The final order I'm going to give you, don't worry. Okay. Allylic carbocations are resonance stabilized. And can I also say this has equivalent resonating structures?
Yeah.
Equivalent resonating structures cause greater stability. Have I told you that earlier?
Yes.
What do you mean by equivalent resonating structures?
Their energy levels are same.
So allylic is more stable even than 2 degree. But it is less stable than this one. Because isme hyperconjugation structures kitne aate hain? ये टर्शरी ब्यूटाइल कार्बोकैटायन है इसमें कितने हाइपर कॉन्जुगेटिव स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं 9 यस सो दोस 9 हाइपर कॉन्जुगेटिव स्ट्रक्चर्स मेक दिस अ मोर स्टेबल कार्बोकैटायन देन अ 1 डिग्री अलाइलिक सो देयर द 9 हाइपर कॉन्जुगेटिव स्ट्रक्चर्स डोमिनेट्स ओवर द रेजोनेंस इन दिस 1 डिग्री अलाइलिक बट इफ आई टेक समथिंग लाइक दिस Can I say this is also a 3-degree carbocation? Yes?
Yeah.
But how many alpha hydrogen in this?
7.
How 10?
7.
2 here, 3 here and 2 here. Yes, 7 alpha hydrogen. No, not 4, 7 ho gaye na? 2 here, 3 here and 2 here. So 7 alpha hydrogen. So this has, though it is 3 degree, but it has less hyperconjugation. This carbocation is less stable than allylic. Okay. Don't worry, I'll give you the final order so that confusion doesn't remain in your mind. All 3 degree carbocations are less stable than allylic, except this one. This one has 9 hyperconjugative structures. That makes this carbocation more stable than allylic. Otherwise, the allylic carbocations are always more stable than 3 degree. Did you all finish writing this? Done with this? Okay. So answer my question here. Arrange these in decreasing order of their stabilities. Give me the most stable first. Sorry, this is 6.
5.
Yes, 5 is the most stable. Reason?
So it has resonating structures. Stable resonating structure.
How many pi bonds in conjugation with that?
2 pi bonds.
Can I say yahan par? Ye shift hoga positive yahan aayega, fir ye shift hoga positive yahan aayega. Correct? Extended resonance. Very good. Yes. Fifth ke baad next kaun hai stability order?
4.
Yes. Fourth one has cross conjugation.
Then 3.
After that?
Ma'am, 6 and 1 mein kaise compare karenge?
6 is 1 degree. You know? This is 2 degree, no? Ye 3 degree hai. Ye vinylic hai.
2. One, six, and seven.
Anyone who's not understood this order. See, all these three are allylic. In fact, this is 3 degree allylic. Ye bhi 3 degree allylic hai. Ye bhi 3 degree allylic hai. Isme extended resonance hai. Isme cross conjugation hai. Aur isme sirf conjugation hai. So extended conjugation makes it more stable than cross, and cross is more stable than conjugation. So that is why we get the order as 5 greater than 4 greater than 3. All these are more stable because all are having resonating structures, which stabilizes them. Uske baad aayega second, because it is a 3 degree carbocation. Then comes a 2 degree. Then will come a 1 degree carbocation, and finally you have the vinylic carbocation. ये vinylic है ना? Vinylic में S character ज़्यादा होता है ना? SP hybridized होता है. तो 50% S character होता है. In fact, vinylic carbocations बनते नहीं हैं reaction के द्वारा, because they need very very high energy to be formed, as their stability is very low. Okay. Did you all finish writing this?
One minute. मैम वो जो विनाइलिक कार्बन है वो sp3 हाइब्रिडाइज्ड है तो उसका बॉन्ड एंगल 180 डिग्री होना चाहिए ना.
हाँ, इसलिए तो बोला मैंने बनते नहीं है विनाइलिक कार्बन. क्योंकि 180 डिग्री वाले कार्बोकैटायन बनते भी नहीं है.
ओके मैम.
जैसे अब ये है, इसको अगर मैं एनर्जी दे रही हूं टू ब्रेक द सीसीएल बॉन्ड, आई एक्सपेक्ट द सीसीएल बॉन्ड टू ब्रेक हेट्रोलिटिक, एम आई राइट?
या
सो अगर सीसीएल बॉन्ड हेट्रोलिटिक ब्रेक होगा तो इस कार्बन पे चार्ज क्या आएगा?
पॉजिटिव.
अदर वर्ड यू गेट अ कार्बो कैटायन. नाउ दो दिस इज 3 डिग्री बट इट इज नॉट फॉर्मड एट ऑल, एंड कुड यू टेल मी व्हाई इट इज नॉट फॉर्मड? This carbocation is on a bridgehead carbon. You know what is a bridgehead carbon, correct?
Yes.
This cannot be formed. This is known as the Bread's rule. Bragg's rule says that you cannot have a strained carbocation which cannot be trigonal planar. Can I say here, though it is sp2 hybridized, yet this carbocation cannot be formed, cannot, because it cannot take that bond angle of 120 degrees. Okay, 120 degrees ka bond angle hona chahiye trigonal planar mein. Am I right?
Yes.
So all these bond angles should be 120, sorry. And can you achieve a bond angle on this bridge head carbon as 120 degrees?
No.
Not possible, na? Because bridge bana hua hai na yahan par. Am I right? So this carbocation
bridge can... out of the plane hota hai na?
हाँ मतलब बाहर होता है. अगर ये ring मैं लिख रही हूँ plane of the board में, तो ये bridge is come, going to come out towards you. It will be something like this. मतलब वो बाहर तुम्हारी तरफ आ रहे हैं. So can I say 120 degree bond angle will not be achieved here? Are you understanding?
Yes.
So here you can never get a carbocation. But again, if I take something like this, यहाँ पर भी क्लोरीन इज ऑन द ब्रिज हेड, बट दिस ऑन हीटिंग विल डेफिनेटली गिव यू द कार्बोकैटायन. एंड व्हाई इज इट सो? व्हाई इज कार्बोकैटायन ऑन दिस ब्रिज हेड फॉर्मड एंड ऑन दिस ब्रिज हेड इट इज नॉट फॉर्मड? गिव मी द रीजन.
मैम ऑन द वन टुवर्ड्स द राइट इट कैन हैव अ SP2, that is
yes,
120 degree
bond
angle.
Exactly 120 degrees. All these bond angles are 120 degrees. So this carbocation can be formed. So according to Bragg's rule says that where trigonal planarity cannot be achieved, the carbocation cannot be formed. Is that clear? Is this understood or no?
Ma'am, can you dictate the definition for Bragg's rule?
Okay, just write down. Bragg's rule says that carbocations cannot be formed. Carbocations cannot be formed on a strained system where planarity cannot be achieved. Carbocations cannot be formed on a strained system where planarity cannot be achieved. Did you all finish writing this? So let's continue now. Now this is an allylic carbocation. And this what I'm writing now is a benzylic carbocation. Which should be more stable and why?
Benzylic.
Reason?
Resonance.
How many resonating structures will you get here?
Two.
This pi 1 will shift out. So where are the positive charges going to go? On ortho and para position? Do you agree?
Yes.
The positive charges will be going on ortho and para position. Fine. So how many resonating structures we have got here? Total will be 4. This carbon having a positive charge, then the ortho carbon having a positive charge, para carbon having a positive charge, and the other ortho carbon having a positive charge. This will have only 2 resonating structures. These are the 2 resonating structures. Can I say both are equivalent resonating structures here? Are these structures equivalent in energy?
No.
Inme se sabse stable wala ye hoga. And what is the reason for that?
Entirely.
Can I say it has a benzene?
Formal charge.
This is aromatic, no? Why it is aromatic? Because it has a benzene ring. So, this is aromatic. The rest are non-aromatic, but this is aromatic. So, can I say this structure will be more stable than the remaining? So, these structures are non-equivalent resonating structures. So, though the number of resonating structures are more in benzylic, yet, can I say the structures are non-equivalent? And isme resonating structures do hi hai. But both are equivalent. So where would
equivalence ko zyada ye hoga. Stability mile.
So phir it is observed that approximately same in stability as compared to the allylic carbocation. Benzylic and allylic are almost similar. This you will use for JE Advanced. But your NCRT says that benzylic is more stable than allylic. This is according to your NCRT. That means agar mains mein pucha to kya bolo, kya likhoge?
Benzylic is greater.
Okay. So JE mains mein you will answer it as benzylic being more stable than allylic. But for JE advanced, we'll be writing benzylic or allylic stability almost similar hai. Because benzylic mein resonating structures zyada hai. But allylic mein jo resonating structures kam hai, par phir bhi wo equivalent resonating structures.
So ma'am, ye logic on mains ke liye kyun nahi use kar sakte? I mean, at the end, the logic is the same, right?
This is actually correct. But then NCRT has not made those changes. So we have to abide by the NCRT, what is given in NCRT for your mains.
Okay.
Because if we write what we want, that is not. Matlab, NCRT ke hisab se hi mains ka paper banaya jata hai. Okay, did you all finish writing this?
Yes, ma'am.
So now I have these five. First one is benzylic. Second is paramethoxybenzylic. Parachlorobenzylic is the third one. Paramethylbenzylic is the fourth one. And paranitrobenzylic is the fifth one. Give me the decreasing order of stability. Most stable first.
Four.
Why four?
बाकी सब में एक्सेप्ट वन में इलेक्ट्रॉन विड्रॉइंग ग्रुप है इसलिए
नहीं, ये थोड़ी इलेक्ट्रॉन विड्रॉइंग है, ये तो देता है. इट विल गिव बाय व्हाट इफेक्ट? प्लस आर है ना ऑक्सीजन का.
यस यस,
ये अपने इलेक्ट्रॉन्स देगा बेंजीन को और बेंजीन इसको ज्यादा देगा. ऑक्सीजन विल डोनेट इनटू व्हिच पोजीशन?
ऑर्थो एंड पैरा.
तो दिस इज इन पैरा, सो दिस विल गेट द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. एम आई राइट?
So then 2 will be most stable.
And for oxygen, the plus R is more than minus I. So most stable is the second one. Second ke baad, it will be the fourth one. Fourth mein methyl group will show what effect?
Plus I.
Plus H also, no? What is plus H?
Hyperconjugation.
It will show hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation here will dominate over... resonance will dominate over hyperconjugation. That makes two more stable than four. Four ke baad.
Fir one.
Haan.
Then five, then three.
Five will be the least stable. Why would five be the least stable? Because nitro will show both minus R and minus I here, correct?
Yes.
And chlorine here will show plus R. Is going to be less than, you know, for all halogens I've told you their resonance effects are weaker than the inductive. I've told you all this.
Yes, ma'am.
So inductive effect ka minus I effect will dominate for halogens, but resonance se wo thoda bahut to deta hai. That makes the third one more stable than the fifth one. Okay. Did you get this order? Are all of you understanding or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now I have taken this compound and I'm heating it so that one of the carbon chlorine bond breaks. Could you tell me which bond will break first, bond A or bond B?
A.
Reason.
Because according to A, the nitro group is in the para position, but B ke respect mein it is in meta position.
Huh. So can I say here the carbocation will be lying in the para position with respect to NO2? Because jab Cl jayega to electron leke jayega, you'll get a carbocation here. Am I right? So the carbocation will be formed in para position with respect to NO2. What effect will nitro show on that carbocation? Both minus R and minus I. Do you agree?
Or A, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Both. And when this bond breaks, a carbocation will be formed here in the meta position with respect to CH2.
So here, inductor.
Here it will show only minus I. So now, where will the carbocation be easily formed? ए में कैसे माय डियर? फ्रॉम दिस कंपाउंड, दिस इज योर ओरिजिनल कंपाउंड, द रिएक्टेंट. आई एम गोइंग टू गेट टू कार्बो कटाइन्स. When this bond breaks, I'll get a carbocation here, which is going to be A. And which this bond breaks, I'm going to get a B carbocation. अब A और B कौन सा less stable होगा दोनों में से?
बी विल बी लेस स्टेबल
Why would B be less stable?
क्योंकि उसके पॉजिटिव चार्ज को नाइट्रोजन से सिर्फ इंडक्टिव इफेक्ट ही एक्सपीरियंस होगा,
हाँ, और वो जो ऊपर वाला नाइट्रो CH2+ है, उसपे क्या
उसमें
होगा?
रेजोनेंस भी होगा।
रेजोनेंस से भी खींच रहा है नाइट्रो, इंडक्टिव से भी खींच रहा है. वो पहले ही इलेक्ट्रॉन डेफिशिएंट कार्बन है. एम आई राइट?
यस, तो सिर्फ बी
सो विच विल बी मोर स्टेबल ऑफ द टू?
बी
सो व्हेन यू आर सप्लाइंग द एनर्जी, दिस इज द एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी फॉर फॉर्मिंग बी, दिस इज द एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी फॉर फॉर्मिंग ए. तो पहले कौन सा बनेगा जब आप एनर्जी दोगे तो? हाँ, समझा. सो कैन आई से द बॉन्ड डिसोसिएशन एनर्जी? बॉन्ड डिसोसिएशन एनर्जी ऑफ बी विल बी लेस देन ए.
मैम, अगर नाइट्रोजन की जगह ऑक्सो मिथाइल होता, इन दैट केस ए पहले बनता ना।
हाँ, ए पहले, ए कार्बो कटायन पहले बनता. तो अगर ऐसा कुछ है मेरे पास, देन द बॉन्ड डिसोसिएशन एनर्जी विल बी
ए ग्रेटर देन बी, सॉरी, बी
नहीं.
ग्रेटर देन ए।
हाँ, दिस एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी इज नथिंग बट द बॉन्ड डिसोसिएशन एनर्जी. फाइन. Can I say a stronger bond will not break easily?
Yes.
So stronger bond will not break easily means I'll have to provide more activation energy to that to break it. Do you agree? A stronger bond will not break easily. So you'll have to provide more energy to break that bond. In other words, you will need more activation energy to break that bond, and therefore the reaction is definitely going to be slower. क्योंकि आपको बहुत ज्यादा एनर्जी देना है, मॉलिक्यूल बहुत ज्यादा स्टेबल है, उसको बॉन्ड ब्रेक करने के लिए आपको बहुत ज्यादा एनर्जी देना पड़ रहा है, मतलब वो रिएक्शन बहुत ही स्लो होने वाला है. इज दिस अंडरस्टूड? इट विल नॉट रिएक्ट इजिली, बट इफ द मॉलिक्यूल इज वेरी रिएक्टिव, दैट मीन्स इट्स बॉन्ड इज गोइंग टू ब्रेक वेरी इजिली, एंड देयरफॉर द रिएक्शन विल बी मच फास्टर. इज दिस क्लियर इन योर माइंड?
Yes.
अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस इज वेरी क्रूशियल, वेरी, इट्स कंपल्सरी. यू डोंट हैव अ वे आउट ऑफ दिस, एंड यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इट हियर. ओके, क्योंकि आगे के सारे रिएक्शंस आई वांट टू यूज ऑल दीस कॉन्सेप्ट्स ओवर देयर. Arrange these three bonds denoted as A, B, C in the order of the decreasing bond dissociation energy. सबसे ज्यादा एनर्जी किसको लगेगा बॉन्ड ब्रेकिंग के लिए?
सी ए एंड देन बी।
And what is the reason? Can I say when this bond is going to break, I'm going to get a 1 degree carbocation? When this bond breaks, I'll get a 2 degree carbocation. And when this bond breaks, I'll get a 3 degree carbocation. 3 degree carbocations are very easily formed. Very easily formed, matlab, if I take plot these on a graph, 3 degree ka stability sabse zyada hai, to wo lowest in energy ho. A 3 degree carbocation is more stable than 2 degree, and 2 degree is more stable than 1 degree. That means when I start heating, this is the energy needed to form a 3 degree carbocation. This is the energy needed to form a 2 degree carbocation, and this is going to be the energy needed to form a 1 degree carbocation. I'll need least energy to form a 3 degree carbocation. So jaise hi main heating chalu karungi, pehle ye bond break hoga, uske baad ye hoga, uske baad ye hoga. Is this understood?
Yeah.
What about the others?
Yes, ma'am.
अब इन तीनों में से स्टेबल सबसे कौन सा ज्यादा होगा?
ट्राइफिनाइल मिथाइल.
वेरी गुड. एंड द रीजन यू ऑल नो, इसमें कितने
रेजोनेंट स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं? ऊपर था डिग्री ऑफ कार्बोकैटायन.
हां, डिग्री से भी, पर इसमें रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स कितने आएंगे? बेंजाइलिक हैज हाउ मेनी रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स? I'm done now here. How many resonating structures were there for benzyl?
वो first वाले को भी consider करना है.
हाँ, क्योंकि positive यहाँ पर भी आएगा, फिर इधर भी आएगा, इधर भी आएगा और इधर.
Then four.
हाँ. So benzylic has 4 resonating structures. How many resonating structures will be possible in diphenyl methyl?
8.
7 ना? This carbon having a positive charge, then the ortho carbon here, para carbon here, ortho carbon here, again the ortho here, para here, and ortho here. So how many carbon atoms are sharing the positive charge here? 7. I repeat, this carbon with a positive charge, then this carbon will have a positive charge, this para wala will have a positive charge, and ortho wala. So तीन यहाँ पर और एक ओरिजिनल इस पे, सो 7 रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर. दिस विल हैव हाउ मेनी?
10.
यस, ओके. 3 ईयर ऑर्थो पैरा ऑर्थो, 3 ईयर ऑर्थो पैरा ऑर्थो, again 3 year ortho para ortho, and one is this original carbon having that positive charge. So this gives you the stability order as triphenyl methyl being more stable than diphenyl methyl, which is more stable than phenyl methyl. Phenyl methyl is also known as benzylic carbocation. Is this done?
Yes.
This one or this one? Paraphenyl benzylic. This is metaphenyl benzylic.
Para.
Haan, reason?
वो पॉजिटिव चार्ज पैरा पोजीशन से नीचे वाले बेंजीन रिंग में भी जा सकता है।
जब ये यहाँ शिफ्ट होगा यहाँ प्लस आएगा, तब ये यहाँ शिफ्ट होगा यहाँ प्लस आएगा, फिर ये भी शिफ्ट हो सकता है, या बेंजीन वाला नीचे वाला भी पार्टिसिपेट कर पाएगा रेजोनेंस में, तो ये भी उसको स्टेबलाइज कर पाएगा। बट हियर ये रिंग उसको स्टेबलाइज नहीं कर पाएगा, क्योंकि ये रिंग कौन से पोजिशन में है? मेटा में। तो मेटा पे इसका पॉजिटिव चार्ज ये कार्बोकैटायन का कभी जाएगा नहीं, सो दिस रिंग विल नॉट बी एबल टू पार्टिसिपेट इन रेजोनेंस, बट दिस रिंग विल डेफिनेटली, एंड देयरफॉर दिस हैज मोर रेजोनेंस सो मोर स्टेबिलिटी। Give me the stability order here. Did you say anything? Are you able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Which of these is the most stable?
Ma'am, इसमें थर्ड वाला में ऑर्थो इफेक्ट होगा।
नहीं, ऑर्थो इफेक्ट सिर्फ बेंजोइक एसिड और एनिलीन में लगाना है, और कहीं पर भी नहीं लगाना है ऑर्थो इफेक्ट, मैंने बताया था। इसमें ऑक्सीजन का क्या इफेक्ट है बताओ, ऑन दैट कार्बोकैटायन? Can I say both plus I, which is going to be dominant over minus I? Am I right? Your oxygen is in meta position. So what effect it will show on the carbocation? Can I say only minus I? Because resonance will sirf ortho para mein jayega. Will it go in the meta position? No. Aur yahan pe kaun sa effect aayega? फिर से प्लस आई, विच इज डोमिनेंट ओवर माइनस आई। सो नाउ हाउ टू कंपेयर बिटवीन द फर्स्ट वन एंड द थर्ड वन? दोनों में प्लस आर है, विच इज मोर डोमिनेंट देन माइनस आई। बट कैन आई से माइनस आई विल बी मोर डोमिनेंट, मतलब इफ आई कंपेयर बिटवीन दीज टू, मिथॉक्सी ग्रुप हियर इज क्लोजर, तो उसका माइनस आई भी थोड़ा सा ज्यादा होगा। That makes 3 less stable than 1. So the final order is 1 greater than 3 greater than 2. Anyone who's not understood here? I'm taking these three compounds, and to each of these, I'm adding silver nitrate. When you see silver nitrate, these silver ions which are present, they are going to remove the chlorine from the molecule, forming silver chloride. So my question to you is, which of these will react with silver nitrate to give a white precipitate of AgCl? Silver is going to take away the chlorine, forming a white precipitate of AgCl. So which of this will react fastest with silver nitrate to give a white precipitate of AgCl? Sorry?
Third one.
First and third. See, अगर यहां से Cl निकला तो कार्बोकटाइन यहां बनेगा. Can I say it will be aromatic carbocation? Why it will be aromatic? It will be that tropelium ion. Have I told you what is a tropelium ion?
No.
I have done resonance with you all, no? Aromaticity किया है मैंने.
हाँ.
Aromaticity में मैंने ये क्या किया नहीं था? Quasi aromatic.
हाँ, quasi aromatic किया है ना.
तो उसमें मैंने ये tropelium ion नहीं बताया था क्या? Cycloheptatrienyl cation.
मैम क्लास नोट्स में तो नहीं है.
एरोमेटिसिटी किया है मैंने.
हाँ मैम.
उसमें एरोमेटिक कार्बोकैटायंस किया था मैंने. कॉजी एरोमेटिक.
कॉजी एरोमेटिक मतलब चार्ज्ड वाले वो भी है.
हाँ, तो वो चार्ज वाले में मैंने साइक्लोहेप्टाट्राइनाइल कटायन नहीं किया है था क्या?
मैम मैं एक और बार चेक करती हूँ. मैम मेरी नोटबुक में मैंने तो नहीं लिखा है, शायद मैं से स्किप हो गया होगा.
ओजस, डिड आई गिव द टर्म ट्रोपीलियम आयन फॉर दिस? For this particular cation, have I said it is tropelium ion? So I think you have not copied it, Disha.
Ma'am, हमने क्या नाम बोला इसका IUPAC?
Cycloheptatrienyl cation. Did you get it? नहीं मिला.
हाँ मैम मिल गया, बट मैंने ट्रोपीलियम नहीं लिखा था.
अच्छा. साइक्लोहेप्टाट्राइनाइल कटायन इज नोन एज ट्रोपीलियम आयन. हाउ मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन रेजोनेंस हियर? हाउ मेनी पाई इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन रेजोनेंस? हाँ. दिस इज गोइंग टू गिव यू एन एरोमेटिक सिस्टम आफ्टर इट लूजेस द सीएल. दिस ऑल्सो विल गिव यू एन एरोमेटिक सिस्टम, दैट इज अ साइक्लोप्रोपीनाइल कटायन. एम आई राइट? But this will give you which system when Cl minus goes from here.
Anti-aromatic.
Huh. So can I say this is not going to react with silver nitrate to give you a white PPT of AgCl? Did you understand this? Only one and three will react with silver nitrate and you'll get a white precipitate of AgCl. Because these two are going to give you an aromatic system. But this will not react because if it gives away the Cl minus, it will change into an anti-aromatic system. So whenever you see silver nitrate now on the arrow, that means they are asking you to form a carbocation. Carbocation will not be formed here in the second molecule. The reason being, the system will turn out to become anti-aromatic system. all these quasi aromatic are more stable than all the carbocations which I have done till now. जितने भी मैंने अभी तक आज एग्जांपल्स लिए हैं सबसे स्टेबल उनमें से ये वाले होते हैं, ये जो कॉजी एरोमेटिक आते हैं। कैन आई प्रोसीड?
यस मैम।
Which of these should be more stable? First one or second one?
Second one.
Reason?
Sorry, first one.
Reason? ऑक्सीजन इज बॉन्डेड हियर, कैन आई से कार्बोकेटायंस आर sp2 हाइब्रिडाइज्ड, तो उसके पास एक एम्प्टी ऑर्बिटल होता है जिसमें दिस ऑक्सीजन कैन गिव इलेक्ट्रॉन्स बाय रेजोनेंस। तो जब ये इलेक्ट्रॉन्स रेजोनेंस से देगा व्हाट चार्ज विल ऑक्सीजन डेवलप बिकॉज ऑफ दैट? Give me the formal charge on oxygen. You'll know how to calculate. You'll know how to calculate formal charge, no?
हाँ मैम, वो पहले ग्राउंड स्टेट में नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स काउंट करो एंड प्रेजेंट स्टेट में नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स काउंट करना।
हाँ, वैलेंस शेल में कितने इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हैं वो देखने हैं। ऑक्सीजन के पास 6 वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स होते हैं, करेक्ट? और यहाँ पर कितने हैं? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5। तो इसके वैलेंस शेल में 5 ही है, होने चाहिए 6, तो इस पे प्लस चार्ज आएगा। दिस इज नोन एज बैक बॉन्डिंग। सो बैक बॉन्ड स्टेबिलाइजिंग दैट कार्बोकेटायन। कैन आई से कार्बन का ऑक्टेट कंप्लीट हो गया? सारे एटम्स का ऑक्टेट कंप्लीट हो गया। यहाँ पर कंप्लीट हो जाता है तो स्टेबिलिटी अचीव हो जाता है। सो बैक बॉन्डिंग के वजह से इसका ऑक्टेट कंप्लीट करवा लेता है। देयरफॉर दिस इज द कार्बोकेटायन व्हिच इज अगेन मोर स्टेबल देन ऑल द कार्बोकेटायंस व्हिच आई हैव डन। इन दोनों में से ज्यादा स्टेबल स्ट्रक्चर कौन सा होगा? रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर, ऊपर वाला या नीचे वाला? Why is the upper one more stable, Ojas? Positive charge on a less electronegative atom. But can I say that here the octet of every element is complete? But in this case, the octet of carbon is incomplete. Do you agree to that? Octet complete wala zyada stable hota hai hamesha. Remember that. Okay. रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स में स्टेबिलिटी ऑर्डर कैसे डिटरमाइन करोगे? द फर्स्ट थिंग यू विल चेक फॉर ऑक्टेट कंप्लीशन। इफ द ऑक्टेट्स आर कंप्लीटेड देन द स्टेबिलिटी विल बी मैक्सिमम। then absence of formal charge. अगर formal charge absent होता है that makes it more stable than the one having a formal charge. And then
हेलो,